osmosis, and in their first descendants were immediately united with the most holy protoplasmos itself, because their common presences were still actualizing the results fully corresponding to it. Before this terrifying cosmic event, the sacred Theomer Colobus that issued from the most holy sun absolute was still in a pure state, without any admixture of extraneously caused arisings having their own subjective properties. And when this sacred Theomer Colobus entered the spheres of those planets on which the sacred crystallizations arose, whose transformations through beings' apparatuses served for the coding and protecting of higher being bodies, these latter required premises exactly corresponding to the required conditions of the sphere of the most holy sun absolutes. But after that common cosmic misfortune, on account of which the sacred Theomer Colobus began to issue from the most holy sun absolute with the admixture of subjective properties coming from extraneously caused arisings, from that time on, the sacred, highest being bodies no longer had the possibility of corresponding to the required conditions of existence in the sphere of the most holy time. This admixture of extraneously caused arisings places the sacred Theomer Colobus under the following hand. I must add, unforeseen causes, when each perfected, highest being body becomes an independent individual and acquires its own law of the sacred premies upon them, this terminates similarly to the most holy sun absolute, with a miniature and when a great many rules were recorded when sacred individuals had been assembled on the most holy sun absolute, then between the emanations of these sacred individuals and the atmosphere of the most holy sun absolute, there was established what is called a geo-premasophonian contact, which brought on this terrible misfortune, the perfected highest being parts of which I have just told you. To be sure, the action of the results of this geo-premasophonian contact soon became harmonized with the already existing action of our most holy sun absolute, and, from then on, the emanations of the sacred Theomer Colobus had to be changed, and the first consequences of this disastrous contact brought about a change in the harmonious movement of many solar systems and produced a disharmony in the inner functioning of certain of their planets. Parts of the being in which the sacred arisings were being coded
Of our microcosmos, either known
your instinctive sense the existence of the holy planet Earth. It is only the three-brain beings on the planet who remain unaware of it, or at least the majority of those who arose shortly before the loss of the continent and the planet's existence disappearance.
Thank you.
As I have already told you, new formation with various properties on becoming a free brain being is gradually being distorted and ultimately turned to dust. In spite of the fact that the initiates of that effort were still relatively normal, responsible beings who did not change their ideas as easily as most contemporary beings. For instance, as people with the blood of play change their gloves, yet the psychosis which then sees all these strange free-brain beings in their desire to find out at any cost whether they have and whether it was immortal, which is so strong and so widespread that this unhealthy need of their psychic stirred up and infected the minds of even the genuine initiates there, who under the influence of this psychosis introduced into the legomenism relating to the whole organic purgatory subject, the confusion in the minds of the initiated beings of the planet Earth at that time came about, in my opinion, chiefly because of that beautiful theory of the Babylonian polis, according to which their existence in otherworldly paradise, and this, hell. And it was just these two expressions, namely, paradise and hell, which in my opinion were the cause of all the subsequent waters. One of the legomenisms about the holy planet purgatory indeed contained both of these words, paradise and hell. But I do not know whether the two words used by the Babylonian Buddhists pertained directly to the legomenism or whether they were used by coincidence. Be that as it may, in the legomenisms about the holy planet purgatory, these two words express the following concept of words. Paradise referred to the magnificence and richness of that holy planet, and the word, hell, referred to that inner state experienced by the highest being bodies who dwell there. That is, a state of constant anguish, grief, and depression. One of the legomenism people gave a detailed explanation of the causes of this state of theirs. It was said that these highest being hearts, or souls, having finally reached this holy planet after incredible sufferings and conscious efforts, having seen and understood the reality and significance of everything existing, and above all seeing our common father endlessness himself so near and so often, became aware that because of the undesirable elements present in them, they were still unable to help him in the fulfillment of his most sacred task for the good of our whole megalocosmos. And so, those two words were evidently just why the poor initiates of that time, infected by the general psychosis, imagined that in that fantastic and beautiful theory of the future, Babylonian Hasnamuses, the same things were spoken of, only more clearly, as they then began that conscious to insert certain details from this fantastic theory into the legomenisms concerning the holy planet afterward. All this information, passing from generation to generation, blossomed out with such embellishments as are here Mullinasaran and expresses by the one word, Rokanatajasana. Single words. As I have just told you, my boy, you can judge what psychic notions and images exist nowadays on your planet about what is called the question of the beyond, and truly says that if these concepts and notions of yours, eccentrics were heard by our hands, they would laugh so hysterically that the same thing might happen to them as happens to your neighbors when they drink what is called castor oil. Understand, and at the same time for a better fairy-like illumination of the meaning of the expressions I just used, hands laughter, and castor oil, I must tell you about another consequence of that. Cunning wise actor, these favorites of yours, in this case concerning the question of being exioherry, as this will give you additional data for elucidating by a concrete example certain particularities that I have already indicated in the fundamental, sacred cosmic law of Kepler Archimedes. After the loss of the continent of Atlantis, certain knowledge concerning the origin and significance of the same, being exioherry, also survived, and this was passed from generation to generation. Well, about 30 or 35 of their centuries ago, after one of their weak processes of reciprocal destruction, when most of their favorites, as usually happens thereafter, these terrible excesses begin to manifest reality more often and to be less satisfied with the conditions of their ordinary existence, it so happened that certain of them, who had sensed very strongly the emptiness of their existence and were seeking the means of somehow filling this emptiness, found out about these surviving fragments of knowledge bearing on the authentic significance of being exioherry. In this fragmentary, yet authentic information, it's very convincingly indicated that by means of the substance, exioherry, or sperm, one of them, it was possible to protect oneself, but unfortunately for them they found no indications in these surviving fragments of what had to be done and precisely how it was to be done. Certain of them then began to think and strive for sense, simply to understand somehow what must be done in order to work for self-protection by means of this substance inevitably formed in their presence. These serious conflicts of theirs led them to the conviction that self, connecting with doubt is actualized simply by abstaining from the injection in the habitual manner of this substance formed in them, sperm, and certain of them deciding to unite and exist together in order to verify and practice whether such abstinence would indeed be the expected results. But however hard these beings of your planet who were the first to be interested in this question strove to clarify it, they arrived at nothing, and it was only their descendants of the second generation, after long conscious observations and intensive active mentation, who at last categorically understood that this was indeed possible, but exclusively on condition of assisting the number being Arnold T. Beauty and certain of the beings of this second generation, as well as the two subsequent generations, after seriously devoting themselves to this, did indeed attain the expected results. But from the fourth generation on, those beings who were still interested in this question no longer followed Orestes' conviction but from a property called imitation, which by that time had become inherent in these terrestrial three-brained beings, yet they also began to exist together and to do, as it were, the same thing. So from that time and even down to the present, these adepts automatically continue to organize themselves in separate groups, and sometimes form substantial sets of different denominations and, basing their aim on this, abstinence, exist together in isolated communities. These places of theirs were segregated communal existence are called monasteries, and the beings belonging to these sects were monks. At the present time, very many of these monasteries exist there, and a large number of monks who enter them may indeed strictly abstain from the injection
Is that